So, something exciting to talk about. The Tesla Semi has just been spotted a couple days ago in St. Louis, Missouri. Yes, St. Louis. What the heck was a Tesla doing in St. Louis? What the heck was a Tesla semi-truck doing in St. Louis? Well, it was actually there, and is actually there, to visit Anheuser Busch Brewery. Why? Because they ordered 40 Tesla semi-trucks and put reservations in for them. That's a lot. Considering that, when you're placing that kind of do-re-mi, you want to kind of see the product up close, personal, and play with it a little bit before you pay the full price, so maybe you could still get your money back, right? So, yeah, now the Tesla Semi is at the Anheuser-Busch Brewery, and they're checking it out, test driving it, and doing lots of good stuff there. But that's not the real crazy thing. I mean, kind of expected that to happen. So let's just go over the list of events. Number one, Tesla semi-truck spotted supercharging in St. Louis. The Tesla Semi occupies two stalls and has an adapter where two stalls can plug into, which converts it to the megacharger plug. You all remember the megacharger plug because yours truly brought you the first and only public images of said megacharger plug. Combining two Tesla supercharger stalls provides up to 240 kilowatt charge rate sustained. Now we're talking, remember, this is a megawatt sized battery, if not larger, a megawatt. It reminds me of an old digital camera commercial from the early 2000s where no one understood the digital camera yet, and the guy in the commercial is going, megapixel, megapixel, and people are just like, ooh, it's over their head. We're talking about megawatts, a big flipping battery. 0 to 90% state of charge, even considering this slower method of charging, since of course Tesla doesn't yet have the mega charger network built, you're talking a 0 to 95% state of charge in 4 hours. That's pretty damn good. 95 to 100% state of charge in another 2 hours. So from 0 to 100%, we're talking 6 hours on the supercharger network, which is really pretty good considering the massive battery pack in this thing. But also considering the massive battery pack means it can sustain that maximum charge rate for a really long time. Now we got to remember, somehow the Tesla Semi was spotted in Fremont 2 days prior to being spotted in St. Louis. Well, how did it go that far that quick? Well, there's at least two drivers, so they could swap out when they're getting tired. They got autopilot, and they really only had to make one, maybe two charging stops that whole route. Now, the Tesla Semi has about a 450-500-mile range pulling a trailer. Now, no trailer on the Tesla Semi means, well, it can go further. I can tell you right now, my Model S can go twice the distance on a charge when I'm not pulling my camper behind us. And we're talking about a semi-truck with a megawatt-sized battery. I'd be surprised if they couldn't make that distance on a single charge. But we'll just say one charging stop right smack dab in the middle. If they got a full 100% charge there, somewhere in the between, maybe someplace in Nebraska, they could have made it all the way then to St. Louis. Maybe worst case scenario, if they wanted to spread it out more, two charging stops, you know, just take a nap. I'm going to get to this in a minute, though. Why it's strange and that it got, because I've done this drive before. I'm actually shorter. It's a shorter drive from here in Milwaukee to Fremont or the Gigafactory. And I've done that drive 3 times now. It takes literally 2 days of driving to do that drive. I mean, if you're doing speed limits or slightly over. I'll get to that in a minute. So, actually, it's a minute later. I've kind of jumped ahead on my list here. So, what does that mean? I theorized back when I brought you the picture of the megacharger port on the very same semi-truck that was spotted in St. Louis. I also kind of went ninja and climbed underneath it. And I also got serial numbers off of drive units and other components. Based on the serial numbers, there is the potential that Tesla has actually made 18 or 20 Tesla semis. Now, I think we would have spotted more of them if they actually did. I said potential, but if they actually did make that many. So based on that, I would not see it out of the realm of possibility that they actually have maybe 4, 5, or 6 actual semi-trucks buzzing around, prototypes here, there, everywhere, because that same semi-truck was actually going from the Gigafactory to Fremont 2 or 3 days before it wound up in St. Louis. So I think that also kind of confirms that they got a couple more built than we actually think. Either way, this was a impressive unshowing show of the vehicle's potential. Somehow it still managed, because this very model managed to get seen at Fremont and the Gigafactory, and it still made it all the way to St. Louis. Tesla didn't have to blow out the fanfare and make a big deal out of it, because they knew as soon as somebody spotted it, boom, it's in the news. Now it is. Very impressive. Very promising. And I can't wait to see more of the Tesla Semi buzzing around. I hope they do like a really cool kind of tour. Tesla, I think you really need to retire the Model X pulling the Airstream trailer as a mobile design studio, because we actually know that you're not actually towing it with the Model X. You're towing it with a Tesla gas vehicle and just using the Model X with it at its stops. But you could very well do it with the semi-truck. Make a semi-truck portable design studio. Ooh, yeah. But as long as we're on the subject, because we got a few minutes left. Now, the implications of a Tesla Semi being able to charge at a supercharger. This is great and bad at the same time. Now, it's unreasonable to think that a Tesla Semi would always be able to charge at a megacharger. I think it would be very possible that they will allow it to always be used at a Tesla supercharger instead of a megacharger, just because there's going to be so many more of them around. But here's how I think that's going to work out. Now, we already know the Tesla Semi is going to be paid supercharging. So my thoughts are, if a Tesla Semi had to charge at a Tesla supercharger, considering the much longer occupation time that it will have at the supercharger, I'm thinking the electrical rates that Tesla will be charging for a semi-truck at a supercharger are going to be higher. What? Who knows? Can't speculate on that yet. But I think it would make sense to discourage the use of a semi at a supercharger, but still allow it if necessary, because charging on anything else is just going to take forever. I think we're at like 27 days to charge a Tesla Semi on 120 volt outlet, 1450 outlet. You got, you know, 3 or 4. I'd say about 4 days on a 1450 outlet, 2 days on a high-powered wall charger, which I'm sure will all be available via adapters and charging plugs. And you gotta get her going. Supercharger can do it, or at least get you enough power to get to a mega charger. I liken a supercharger is to a mega charger as a standard J1772 is to a supercharger. Yeah, that's the speed difference, because Also, based on numbers and calculations, a megacharger should be able to put out approximately 1.6 megawatt charge rate to be able to hit Tesla's charging claims. And that's if they don't make it better, because Elon's great at upstaging and doing one up. So that's what I have for you right now. It's just fun, exciting, awesome.